There's a countless amount of techniques that we violinists can learn, and sometimes it can feel pretty overwhelming. And third position is only one of these many techniques. Before you decide if it is worth it learning it to you, I would like you to weigh out the benefits of learning the third position so you can decide if this is a project you would like to take on. And if by the end of the video you decide to learn third position, I will also let you know which other videos to watch so you can get started learning right away. The first benefit of learning third position is one of the benefits that is most exciting for students, and that is that you can play two more notes on the E string. Two more notes, it doesn't sound like a lot, but it means that you can play a whole lot more pieces on the violin, because there happens to be a lot of pieces that use exactly these two notes. The two notes that you can play in third position that you cannot play in first position are the C and the D. Let's have a look at these two notes. The C is over here and is just above the regular place of the fourth finger. And the D is over here. And is the fourth finger in third position. The first two fingers in third position can also be played in first position. This is the first finger in third position, which is the A. And the second finger in third position, which is the B. But they can also be played as 3 and 4 in first position. So in the end, you have two completely new notes that you can play in third position. The second reason to learn third position is that playing in third position can be easier than playing in first position. You might think like, wait a second, Julia, it is so hard to play in third position. Normally I can't even find it, and that is very normal in the beginning. If you just start learning third position, it can feel endlessly difficult. But after you've practiced third position for a while, you might notice that some pieces are actually easier to play in third position. For instance, if you would have to play this run, you are crossing strings all the time. It would be a lot easier to play that in third position. The third position allows you to bypass some difficult runs, some difficult string changes, some difficult note patterns across strings. Sometimes you can just stay in one string and that will make it a lot easier. So third position can actually make violin playing easier in the long run. The third reason to learn to play in third position is that you can play with a different sound color. Different sound color, you might say? Yes, there is actually such a thing as a sound color. It is not the note that you play, the note is the same, but you can play the same note with different types of fields or sound colors. For instance, listen to this open A string. The open A string sounds pretty open, but also pretty harsh. Now let's have a look at the A in third position. You will notice it sounds a lot softer and also a little bit deeper. The reason for that is not only that we are playing it with a finger as opposed to an open string, which makes it sound softer in general, but also that we are playing it one string lower, and generally the lower strings sound a little bit more deep. So for instance, if you want to play specific notes on a lower string to make it sound a little bit more soft, more deep, a bit more romantic in my opinion, then learning third position is really worth it. Especially if you want to learn very specific pieces that have this very beautiful, romantic feel. You want to learn how to play third position in order to play these pieces really beautifully. The fourth reason for learning third position is that it will help you to learn shifting. Most commonly, the third position is the first new position that violinists learn after learning the first position. And then you shouldn't only learn a new position, but also a new technique, which is called shifting. Shifting is the changing between two positions. And it is so valuable to learn how to do that. This is what shifting looks like. If you're playing in first position for a while, you might want to continue and play some other notes in third position. But for that, you have to shift. Shifting looks like this. And it is just the change of the hand position. And this might just look very easy if you look at me doing it, but actually, it can be pretty hard to learn, especially when you're playing a lot of notes in between and also have to make the correct hand motion. Learning how to shift will really help you, because it will be useful in learning any other position. That is also why learning third position is often very hard for new students, because they don't only have to learn the third position, but also how to shift. But again, as I said, learning how to shift is such a valuable skill. It won't help you to learn only third position, but also all the other positions that are higher on the fingerboard. And that will really extend your reach on the violin and will help you to be able to play so many more notes than you would be able if you would not know how to shift. The fifth reason for learning third position is also connected to the first reason, actually, and that is that you can play so many more pieces. And which violinist doesn't want to learn more pieces? Especially if you love classical music, the third position is a must-have skill in your violin repertoire. There's just so many beautiful pieces that you could play if you would only be able to play the first and the third position. That might include some of your favorite pieces that you always wanted to learn. For instance, one of the pieces that I couldn't wait to learn when learning third position was the Vivaldi Concerto in A minor. I just love this piece and it just really motivated me to learn the third position. Maybe you have such a piece as well, and if you have such a piece, please post it in the comments to let others know, because this is really going to motivate not only you to learn it in the end, but also the others to see what kind of beautiful pieces there are in third position. So now you know all the benefits of learning third position, how should you go about learning it and when should you actually start learning it? I think, first of all, what you should know is that the skills that you should have before learning third position is that you can play in first position in tune, and that you have a fair amount of pieces that you played in first position, so you feel comfortable playing in first position. Also, you are having the right bow hold, and you find it pretty easy to just bow back and forth. You don't have any trouble with that anymore. That is the time that you should be learning third position and challenge yourself again. Because maybe the first position isn't as challenging anymore. If you're not at that level yet, don't worry. There's so many free resources on this channel to get to that level. First of all, I recommend to go to my website because there's a video library and there you can select beginner level and basics level. And please just play as many pieces of that level as possible. Play your skills as well. I wrote an article on my website which is called The 5 Most Common Skills. And you should learn all 5 of them to really get comfortable in first position. And also get comfortable making beautiful long bow strokes, getting very comfortable with the bow hold. I also wrote an article and made videos on that, so have a look at that as well to really get into the right bow hold. And in that way you can prepare yourself to get ready for learning third position later on. If you are already ready to learn third position, if you checked all those boxes that I've just shared with you, then I recommend to go ahead and have a look at my third position playlist on my channel. Here I share all the resources to learn third position. And also on my website there's an article which is called How to Learn Third Position or something like that. I will check it out and link it down below this video. And there I lay out all the videos of learning third position, the skills that you should learn, how to shift to third position, and everything else you need to know in order to learn how to play beautifully in third position. That being said, I wish you good luck learning third position. And please give this video a thumbs up if it helps you to get started and to get an idea of what the benefits are. If you are excited to learn third position now, please also post it down in the comments. Let me know if you are going to learn it. If a lot of my subscribers are going to learn third position, that will really motivate me to create more content around it, like songs in third position, exercises in third position, and more. So definitely let me know if you are going to learn it. Also, if you want to stay updated on the third position videos that I will be posting on this channel, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification button so you don't miss your weekly violin lessons. Every week I post new violin lessons, so if you follow along every week, you will get a little bit better at violin playing every week. Okay, I think that's all, so I'm going to sign off now. Thank you so much for watching and see you next week for the next violin lesson. Bye bye!